हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल जर्नी विथ विजय कुमार श्रीवास्तव। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू प्रेजेंट द टॉपिक स्टोर्ड ग्रेन पेस्ट कंट्रोल मेथड्स। बिफोर प्रेजेंटेशन आई वुड लाइक टू इंट्रोड्यूस माय सेल्फ इन ब्रीफ। आई एम विजय कुमार श्रीवास्तव। आई हैव डन एमएससी एग्रीकल्चर विथ स्पेशलाइजिंग एग्रोनॉमी एंड प्रेजेंटली एसोसिएटेड विथ सीड इंडस्ट्री वेयर रिलेटेड टू हाइब्रिड सीड प्रोडक्शन एक्टिविटीज ऑफ फील्ड क्रॉप्स। दिस वीडियो इज एक्सक्लूसिवली prepared to support the students who are preparing for various agriculture competitive examinations and hope this will be useful to all of them. So let's move on. As stored grain pests are concerned, insects are having the prime importance as they are responsible for major losses. Insects are important pests of cereals, grains and stored fruits. Under optimum conditions, many of the species can complete their life cycles in less than 30 to 35 days and lay many eggs. This results in rapid build-up and multiplication of populations that consume and contaminate various stored products. Stored product insects are in most cases insects of a small size with a high productive potential. Therefore, they are easily concealed in grain and grain shipment and have been carried to all parts of the world. As the nature of damage is concerned related to insects, there will be loss of products. Because of insect infestations, we can't supply the sufficient quantity required volumes. There will be qualitative changes because after infestation of insects, the stored material will not be in position to consume, as there will be deterioration in quality. There will be damage to structures of godowns, because of which the storing facilities needed to be corrected, and there will be health hazards because of infestation of such insects. Second type of stored insect pests are secondary pests. These are the pests which are surviving by feeding on already damaged grains or seed caused by primary pests. So these secondary pests are feeding on grain that is damaged or going out of condition. The presence of secondary pests indicate that this stored grain or seed is not at optimal condition, and measures should be implemented immediately to protect the grain or seed from a further decline in quality. The secondary pests are often classified as external feeders. The characteristics of external feeders can be defined as most adults are red-brown to black color, and these are having hardened cells. And these insect pests are having inhabit any portion of the grain as they are feeding externally outside. The external feeders are found predominantly where there is abundance of broken kernels or damaged kernels and presence of fungus on moist grain conditions. These external feeders are often described as secondary pest, as bran bugs or fungus feeders. Some examples of secondary pests are Indian meal moth, sawtooth grain beetles, rusty grain beetles, hairy fungus beetle, red flower beetles and dermestid beetle. Now sources of infestation. There are various sources because of which the store grain pests are multiplying in storage sites and they are causing the damage to the stored material. These factors or sources can be defined as first one field. If in fields there is infestation of insect, there are chances that with the crop harvested produce or crop residue, it may be transported to the storage sites. Second is carried over commodities. If commodities are already infested and they are carried to the storage points, so chances are there that it will infest the other commodities also. Another sources are wastes and rejects. If the wastes and rejects are there, these are more susceptible to the insect multiplications and it can attract them. So these are one of the sources by which the insect may move to the stored grain. Agriculture machineries are another sources. If you are using these machinery, harvesters or implements or some other processors in the fields also. So if the infested grains are there, it may carry it to the storage points. There are another means of transportation, which are also one of the kind of source for the insect infestation methods. So the transport means should be also cleaned thoroughly. And there are alternative hibernation sites and host from where the spread is taking place. There are some basic steps in insect control. In order to control insect in a storage warehouse or processing plant, there are various steps which must be followed. Like first one is monitoring, under which there should have an inspection or surveillance program which will yield prompt awareness of a possible problem like presence of insect pest or label or sources before it occurs and cause severe damage. There should be identification by which to determine the extent and nature of the possible problem, like which is a species, which type of insect and what is the level of infestation and means of transmission. Third step is control. After getting monitoring and identification, then we have to follow the control measures. Devise a plan for controlling the problem, like there should be integration of all possible means to achieve good, cheap and safe pest control methods. Integrated pest management of stored produce pests. The control methods of stored produce pests can be categorized in different measures like preventive and curative measures. Under preventive measures, first one is hygiene and sanitation, where there is need of good plant design, sweeping, vacuum cleaning and efficient disposal of infested debris. There should be proper staking by which we can take the control, supervision, the monitoring of the stored material. And there should be disinfestation of storage containers, structures and stores, and time being the all measures should be taken. And fourth is use of monitoring devices, like we can use light traps, which is mainly used for cigarette beetles and this flower moth. After that, pheromone traps are also used, where the delta traps are used for anchois grain moth or Indian meal moth. And there are also flower traps used for sawtooth grain beetle, drug store beetle, etc. Under curative measures, There are various methods which are used, like ecological methods, mechanical methods, physical methods, cultural methods, botanical produce use, these chemical methods, then biological and engineering structures, about which we will discuss in detail. These preventive measures, there are various steps which should be taken to avoid the any infestation of the insect to the severe level. Under such preventive measures, there should be drying of the grains to a moisture range of 10 to 14% based on grain type, which will avoid majority of the damage. Drying can be done under sunlight or using any developed dryers. After harvesting of the grains before shifting to storage, certain measures have to be taken to avoid the initial infestation or inoculum of storage pests. Selection of a storage site is prerequisite, which involves removing of dirt, debris, foreign particles, other insect pests, these infested grains that will reduce to avoid initial infestation. Handling of grains should be proper and the structure should not be damaged. Proper stacking size and wooden drainage should be maintained to avoid from mechanical damage or to keep away from wall. Between each stakes, a proper space should be maintained for the time being monitoring and identification of any pest if available. Sometimes the initial infestation observed in field can be managed with exposing the grains for sunlight for shorter period. Using of improved storage structures are important. In Indian conditions, grains are storing variedly from small metal bins to bulk storage in gunny bags under warehouses. Hermetic storage concept developing can be exploited for the future. Jute bags are generally using, which are additionally suggesting to amalgamate with polythene lining bags. New harvested lots that should be stored separately and should have isolated distance with old stocks. It will prevent new stock to be infested with older stocks if by means the pests are available there. Several improved bins are available these days, which are developed by different institutes for Indian conditions, like Pusa bin, PAU bin, Tamil Nadu Agriculture University developed bins and others. Disinfestation of bulk and bag storage structures using insecticide is also an important practice to be done prior to storage, and a layer of insecticide spray can be suggested immediately after storage. Under preventive measures, we have to clean the machines like harvesters and thresher or processing machines before they are used to avoid any fresh infestations. Now we have to also check the trucks, trolley or bullock carts transport means, and it should be free from infestations. We have to clean the godowns or storage structures before storing the newly harvested crop to eliminate various biostages of pest hiding inside. We have to provide a metal sheet up to a height of 25 cm at the bottom of the wood indoors to arrest the entry of rats, rodents. And we have to fix up wire meshes to windows, ventilators, gutters, drain, etc. to prevent entry of these rodents like rats, birds and squirrels. And move and destroy dirt, rubbish, sweeping materials, webbing, etc. from the stores. And we have to close all the rat burrows found in the godown with a mixture of broken glass pieces and mud plasters with mud and cement. As a preventive measures, there should be plastering of the cracks, crevices, holes found on wall and floors, and we have to provide drainage leaving gangway or LLway of 0.75 to 1 meter all around to maintain good storage conditions, and store the food grains in rat and moisture proof storage structures, and disinfect the storage structures receptacles by spraying malathion or other chemicals. Under curative measures, first method is ecological methods, where the importance is given to the storage temperature, these grain moisture content and availability of storing conditions moisture. So we have to maintain the ambient temperature and the desired grain moisture content depending upon the crop and its varieties, and storage conditions moisture to prevent from insect infestations. We can manipulate the ecological factors like temperature, moisture content and oxygen through design and construction of a storage structure to make the conditions which are unfavorable for attack by insects. Temperature above 42 degrees centigrade and below 15 degrees centigrade retards reproduction and development of insect, while prolonged temperature above 45 degrees centigrade and below 10 degrees centigrade may kill the insects. So as per the need based, we can go for the alteration of the storage conditions. Dry the produce to have moisture content below 10% to prevent the building up of pests. Kill the pest bio stages hardened in the storage bags, beans, by drying in the sunlight. And we have to store the grains at around 10% moisture content to escape from the insect attack. Manipulate and reduce oxygen level by 1% to increase the carbon dioxide level automatically, which will be lethal to all the stages of insects. Next is mechanical methods, under which we can go for screening by using gravity screens, perforated auger, rotary screens, pre-cleaners, which will be helpful to sort out all the debris and infested material from the stored grain or seed. There should be sieving to keep out insect attack by removing broken and cracked grains. And a screen should be destroyed immediately and it should not be used for the another product, otherwise there may be chances of infestations. And we have to stitch all torn out bags before filling the grains. There are use of grain protection devices also, like insect egg remover, insect prop trap, insect stack trap and UP light trap for go down. So these all methods are used as a mechanical measures. Next is physical methods, under which there are different methods which are used. Like first one is temperature management. Increasing or decreasing the temperature can alter the insect growth and metabolism. Optimal temperature for most of the storage insect is in between 25 to 33 degrees centigrade. Deviations from these points will slow down the growth and continuously to death. Passing of dry or wet heat in the storage system or refrigerated aeration yields better results. Even it can be achieved by using high frequency waves, providing a superheating system by infrared heaters in the flour mills and food processing plants to obtain effective control of pests, since mostly the stored pest insects die at 55 to 60 degrees centigrade in 10 to 20 minutes. So these are the temperature management which are used to control the insect pest. Second is mixing of inert dust. Inert dust like clay, sand, ash, minerals, silica in the form of silicon dioxide are effective in managing the insects by moisture loss of the insect body by abrasion. Dust that contain natural silica such as diatomaceous earth are commercially available and using in many developing countries either to manage or to improve fumigation efficiency. Activated clay kaolin has also been used in protecting grains from the attack of storage insects. And these inert materials desiccate the cuticles of insects, and its efficacy will be depend on size, shape and form, and humidity maintained. Third physical method is irradiation. Irradiation in lower dose can able to kill or sterilize the common grain pests and even the eggs deposited inside the grains. Radiations like microwaves, X-rays are utilizing in several forms to treat the grains before storage to disinfest them. Fourth method is use of controlled atmosphere. A novel methodology where the storage atmosphere generally contains 78% nitrogen, 21% oxygen, and 0.03% carbon dioxide. This proportion can be altered mechanically by altered atmosphere, which interfere with the normal insect metabolism, which achieve motility. We can modify the storage atmosphere to generate low oxygen, 2.4%, and to develop high carbon dioxide, 9.5, by adding carbon dioxide to control the insect. The controlled atmosphere can be achieved by adding carbon dioxide to maintain 9 to 10%, by adding nitrogen, or by addition of both nitrogen and carbon dioxide, or by reducing the oxygen to the level of 2 to 4%. Now, fifth method is mechanical devices and traps. Devices developed for monitoring and mass trapping, such as insulators, which are using in flour mills. Apart from these, some other traps like probe traps, pulse beetle trap, light traps, sticky traps, bait traps, and pheromone traps were also developed and tested in some of the countries. Next method is biological control methods, under which semiochemicals and biopesticides are used. Semiochemicals are the chemicals which are used to change the behavior of insect pest. Much of the behavior of insect pest of stored products is associated with the search for food, sexual partners, and egg-laying sites, together with defensive activities to protect them from adverse environmental conditions and natural enemies. This behavior is modified by chemical signals produced either by the insects themselves or by other organisms, including the plants upon which they feed. The semiochemicals are of two types. First one is pheromones and second is allelochemicals. Pheromones are the chemical signals from one organism that stimulate a response in another individual of the same species. And pheromone traps are used to cause mating disruption between male and female insect pest to prevent the multiplications. These pheromones are of two types. First one is sex pheromones, where the female produces pheromone which attracts male, and second is aggregation pheromones, which attracts both males and females. The most commonly used pheromones are used for Ploidea interpunctata, Lesioderma sericon, Tribolium casnesium, and Pectinophora gossypiella. Now, allelochemicals. Allelochemicals are chemical produced by living organisms that exerts a detrimental physiological effect on individual of another species when released into the environment. Means these chemicals are produced by one organism which is causing impact on other organisms. As a control methods, the insect traps are available for some of the insects like flour beetles and Lepidopteran insects. Now, biopesticides. Some of the commercially available entomopathogenic fungi against field crop pests like Viverria vesiana, Metahergium ensipoli, and Bacterium bacillus thuringiensis were tested majorly against stored grain pest, especially for beetles. So these are the biological control methods. Next method is botanical usage. Plant extracts are commonly referred to as botanicals, like neem leaf powder, black pepper, turmeric powder, sweet flag rhizomes powder, etc. These are secondary plant metabolites and extremely low toxic to mammals and working against insects only. These botanicals are killing or working as a repellent to make seed unsuitable for insect pest. There are different formulations like tablets, pellets, oil, powders are developed, and these are under use for commercialization. There are different botanicals like neem ajal, which is derived from neem plant Azadirachta indica. There are plant oils, which are derived from Helianthus anus sunflower, methanol extracts from chrysanthemum, petroleum ether extracts from Azadirachta indica neem tree, leaves, bark and seeds powder from Calotropis procera, and plant oil from Glycinemax soybean. And these extracts are used to control the storage grain pests. Botanicals can be for the management of a stored grain pest without any adverse effect on germination, as per report Mamun and Shahjahan in 2011. As per report from Athanasiou et al. In 2005, Azadirachtin, which is derived from the neem tree, causes 100% mortality to rice weevil. As per report from Darwala 2012, methanol extracts from chrysanthemum reduce the population of khapra beetle, and neem oil at the rate 1 ml 100 gram of seed controls 99% pulse beetle population in cowpea seeds. So these are the use of botanicals to control the store insect pests. Next method is chemical methods. When most of the methods like physical methods, mechanical methods, botanicals, these ecological methods are not becoming useful and not giving the proper control, in such cases, application of chemicals becomes essential to complete insect mortality and prevention of insect growth. The chemical methods features for two broad types of treatment. First one is treatment by contact insecticides, which consist of surface treatment and seed treatment, and second is treatment by fumigation. Under surface treatment, the treatment is given to the gunny bag surface, walls, these floors and other godown structures. And under seed treatment, the seed is directly treated with chemicals, sprayed with chemical to make it safe from the insect pest. The chemical methods consist of covering the grains with a film of insecticide that act on contact with insects with effects that vary in rapidity and persistence. These products come in various forms like powders for dusting, powders to be mixed with water, liquid concentrates or fumigants that dictate their techniques of applications. Under the chemical surface treatment, the gunny bags are getting disinfected by dipping them in 0.01 to 5% fenvalerate of 20 EC or cypermethrin 25 EC for 10 minutes. And these gunny bags should be dried in shade before filling with grains. As an alternate, otherwise we have to use new gunny bags to prevent infestation of storage grain pests. We can disinfect empty godowns or receptacles by spraying 0.05% malathion emulsions on the floor, walls and ceiling. Other chemicals suitables are also used. Surface treatment is given to the different godown structures, walls, floors, damaged portions or gunny bags to prevent it from insect pest infestations. As an alternate way, we can use improved storage receptacles. The grains can be best protected by using improved insect-proof receptacles of various types. These are classified in two types. First one is indoor bins and second is outdoor bins. Under indoor bins, which are used for a small storage like domestic metal bins, gharelu theka, pakka kothi, welded wire mesh bins, reinforced cement ring bins and extra mud structures, which are used as a small scale for a small volume of storage. And second is outdoor bins, where we can use different bins like flat and hopper bottom metal bins, composite bins, partially underground and above ground structures, in which half storage will be inside the ground and half will be above ground. There are seed storage bins, ferro cement bins and pusa bin. Improved godowns are there, bulk storage installations and vacuum process storage facilities are there. Next method is seed treatment. Different chemicals are used for seed treatment like melathion, phenvalerate, cypermethrin, deltamethrin in different doses depending upon the requirement. Melathion is used for seed treatment, and the grains treated with melathion should not be sold or consumed for 7 days, and melathion is registered to use on only cereal grains and not permitted to use on oil seeds. Against pulse beetle, we have to cover the pulse stored in bulk with 7 cm layer of sand or sawdust or dung ash, because these beetles are mostly active in upper layers, so we can protect the produce. Do not mix synthetic insecticide with grains which are meant for human consumption, and also don't spray the insecticide directly on food grains as a safety measures. Now to study about contact insecticides applications. For grain that is to be stored in bulk, the insecticide is incorporated directly into the grain by spraying before the silos are filled. For storage in bags, previously cleaned grain is mixed with powder or sprayed before bagging. In order to avoid reinfestation of grain stored in bags, further repeated dustings or sprayings are carried out while the bags are being stacked and during the storage period. The machinery used for dusting grain can range from the simple mechanical duster to motorized dusters. However, with this type of equipment, the grain is not treated uniformly, some areas receiving more dust than others, so there will be uneven sprays. Spraying can be mechanical, it may be by pressure sprayers, pneumatic or thermal, and it provides a better distribution of the product over the grain. In big storage centers, in order to obtain an even more regular distribution and a good coating of insecticides, the grain is fine sprayed by a compressor equipped with a mist nozzle. Although contact systems of treatment are certainly effective on fully developed insects, they have little or no effect on the larva or eggs. Furthermore, some residue of the product, though not highly toxic, may linger in foodstuffs. Now, treatment of grain by fumigation. What is fumigation? Fumigation is a treatment that treats stored grain of insects by means of a poisonous gas. This substance produced and concentrated as a gas which is lethal for a specific living species. Unlike contact powders, the fumigant penetrates to the interior of the grain mass and reaches the largely invisible incipient forms which may reach to eggs, larvae which are developing there. Fumigants spread throughout the area were released, therefore used in totally sealed enclosures. Fumigation should be done and made leakage proof. When grains stored in bulk is fumigated, the bins must be perfectly airtight. For grains stored in bags, the usual method is to cover the bags with a tarpaulin whose edges are sealed to the ground or to the walls. The effectiveness of fumigation depends on one hand on the actual concentration of the gas and to the other hand on the length of time during which the grain is fumigated. In fumigations, the fumigants are used. Generally, there are two types of fumigants which are available for fumigation purpose in grain storage program. First one is methyl bromide. Methyl bromide has a quick action and the grains can be aerated after 12 to 14 hours of its application. However, this methyl bromide is highly toxic, colorless and odorless, and it has residual effect in the grain and accumulates in the human body. For this reason, methyl bromide was phased out and should not be used as a fumigant in grain storage program. Second is magnesium or aluminium phosphide. The gas released from this chemical is known as phosphine, and it is used like alphos, sulfos, phosphium and quickphos. This fumigant has a small molecular weight and thereby it has excellent penetration capacity. The weight of phosphine gas is similar so that of air, so it is easily get mixed with air and spread all along the stored grains. This eliminates the need to have recirculating fans to circulate the air, and this is very effective against most of the pests. Aluminium phosphide doesn't affect taste or smell of the fumigated grain. At the same time, it leaves no residue on the grain, so it can be safely used for food grains. In fumigation process, metallic drums or wooden boxes can be used for fumigating a small quantity of grain. In India, ethylene dichloride and carbon tetrachloride mixtures have been recommended for fumigation of food grains in storage at farm level, and hydrogen phosphide in the form of aluminium phosphide or methyl bromide for protection in warehouses, godowns and silos. Earlier, methyl bromide was used at the rate of 3.5 kg per 100 cubic meter of space with 10 to 12 hours exposure. Now, due to its toxicity and its as a residue in food grains, it has been phased out. The fumigant hydrogen phosphide aluminium phosphide is available in tablet form. That aluminium phosphide is recommended for cover fumigation, where the 3 tablets of 3 gram each used for per tonnage of grain storage. For seed fumigation, there is use of 25 tablets for 3 gram each for the space of 100 cubic meter with exposure period of sedge. Sand snakes are used in case of cover fumigation, and nowadays precipitated silica is also used against stored pests. Next method is cultural methods. In cultural methods regarding pulse storage, we can split and store for longer time. As the pulse beetles are attacking, preferring on whole pulses, and they having less impact on split ones. So, in case of split pulses, we can store the material up to the longer period. Another is store the food grains in airtight sealed structures to prevent the infestation by the insects. Another cultural method is parboiling of paddy. The parboiling refers to the hydrothermal treatment followed by drying before milling for the production of milled parboiled grain. Because of this parboiling, there will be killing of all insects present in paddy seeds or paddy grain. Another method is use of engineering methods, engineering control measures. Like first one is super grain bags. Super grain bags reduce the flow of oxygen and water between the stored grain or seed and the outside atmosphere. When properly sealed, respiration of grain and insect increases oxygen levels from 21% to 5%. This reduction reduces insects to less than 1 insect per kg of grain without using insecticides, often within 10 days of sealing, and it increases the germination and lifespan of seed or grain. Second is use of plastic containers, which is very important. The container should be airtight to prevent moisture from getting into seeds. Another is use of silo bags. Silo bags are actually bags which is made up of polyethylene and hence popularly referred to as polythene bags as well. These bags are made up of 3 layers of polythene, which provides a total thickness of 250 microns. And this bag is sealed in airtight. It is designed to stretch by 10%, ensuring the grain is packed tightly and most air is expelled at filling. The inside of the bag has become anaerobic conditions. Because of this, these bags provide fungus control and insect control. And these silo bags are not suitable for longer period storage. So these are the some engineering control measures which are used to protect from insect pest attack during storage conditions. So this presentation was all about storage grain pest control methods. Hope this will be useful to all of you. Thank you very much. I have given here my YouTube channel details, Journey with Vijay Kumar Srivastava. Having request, please visit the channel, subscribe it, and provide your kind and valuable feedbacks. Thank you.